Time for some local corporate stories, starting with Aboitiz Power Corporation. Its newly appointed CFO, Sandro Aboitiz, is confident the firm will continue its growth momentum on the back of its new energy projects that are set to contribute to the Philippine grid soon. He says these projects include the company's 94-megawatt Cayango solar plant in Pangasinan, its 159-megawatt Lawag solar plant in Pangasinan, as well as its 24-megawatt battery energy storage project in Magat. All are expected to start delivering by next year. Meanwhile, the Ayala Group's real estate investment trust arm is set to embark on its most significant acquisition this year. A-REIT is set to receive Ayala Land's flagship Makati assets and prime hotels totaling 23 billion pesos. The company also plans to purchase a 6.77 billion pesos industrial land property from Buendia Cristiana Holdings Corporation. And finally, for the Bank of Commerce, the affiliate of San Miguel Corporation taps Infosys Finacle to accelerate its digital transformation. Infosys Finacle, according to the bank, is a global leader in banking technology. It will replace Bancom systems with newer and more efficient technology. The Philippine Treasury Bureau raises 100 billion pesos from the sale of treasury bonds this month. This is over 23% lower than the targeted 130 billion pesos to be borrowed from the local debt market. The BTR held 5 T-bonds auctions in November, and rates demanded by investors for those auctions were mixed. British businessmen are optimistic of an extension of the Philippine government order, which lowered tariffs on swine meat. President Marcos's Executive Order No. 10, which has benefited the British pork industry, expires at the end of the year. BCCP Executive Director Chris Nelson told ANC, UK pork has significantly helped with food security and the fight against inflation here in the Philippines. He also sees the trend continuing with the extension of the reduced tariffs.
The Tariff Commission itself was actually, and the government itself, the economic team, were in favor of extending this. And I think based on what we've seen and the trends, and the fact that it's important to keep inflation, which is a key target for a lot of governments around the world, then clearly extending the lower tariffs will help in the fight of inflation. So I think our optimism is based upon, obviously, the work we've done, the fact that this is in line with the approach, and needed as well, because also there was an indication there could be a shortage of pork, specifically, obviously, at this time of the year.
Here at home, the Philippine government is urged to reduce its dependence on China to fund its big-ticket infrastructure projects. Public policy think tank InfraWatch PH made that call amid the two nations' maritime row. This is in response to NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan's recent statement that sought to separate the Philippines' economic relations with China from the territorial dispute. InfraWatch convener Terry Ridon says economic dependencies can become geopolitical vulnerabilities. He adds the Philippines' economic strategies should not leave it exposed to external pressures. Ridon also says the government should look at tapping other international funding sources that respect the country's sovereignty and offer more favorable terms.
Global economic growth seen to slow slightly next year, but the risk of a hard landing has subsided. That's according to the Organization of Economic Cooperation and Development, or OECD. It says the global economy will expand by 2.9% this year before weakening to 2.7% in 2024. That's due to the impact of tighter financial conditions, weaker trade growth, and lower business and consumer confidence. The OECD adds the pace of growth is uneven, with emerging markets generally faring better than advanced economies.
Emerging Asian economies are expected to continue to drive a substantial share of global growth in the next 2 years. More generally, GDP growth in most emerging markets is holding up better than in advanced economies. India is seeing surging services exports and public investment, which will continue to drive the economy. Growth in Indonesia, Brazil, and Mexico remains strong. So we're projecting a soft landing for advanced economies, but this is far from guaranteed. In our central projection, disinflation continues towards targets, while growth temporarily slows before recovering again in 2025.
San Miguel Corporation boss Ramon Ang is being recognized for his charitable works. The tycoon is the lone Filipino in Forbes Asia's 2023 Heroes of Philanthropy. According to Forbes, Ang pledged 500 million pesos this year to build schools for underprivileged children in Manila. It also noted that since 2020, Ang has personally contributed around 150 million pesos in scholarships and grants, while the San Miguel Foundation has given away billions of pesos to build schools, clean up rivers, and support COVID-19 pandemic relief measures. Ang told Forbes he believes empowering Filipinos in less privileged areas with education and skills is key to unlocking the country's potential.